The Fishing News is brought to you by Shoreline Insurance Agency, Intelux Marine Paint, and Okuma.
Hey folks, Fred Golofaro here for the Fisherman's Video Fishing Forecast, and really not a lot to report in the way of fishing. Some good news on the freshwater front we'll get to in a minute. As far as the cod fishing goes, it's been pretty much focused on the east end, at least the better fishing. Monday, the Viking 5-star got out. Captain Steve reported a great day. They got on the fish really good. He had a group of guys that came out with Captain Jeff from the Voyager. They said it started out a little slow, but by mid-morning they found a pile of fish and just loaded up, ended up with over 100 nice cod for the day. The Viking Starship also got out on Monday. Same thing, you know, a little bit of a slow start. They finally got into a good bite, late morning pick of cod, and ended up with cod with a decent catch of cod up to 18 pounds. Along the South Shore, not a lot of boats getting out, especially during the week. Spoke to guys from the Captree Princess. They said they picked a few last weekend on the Captain Al. Pretty much the same story. Picked a handful of cod and a few ling on the weekend. Everybody hoping that fishing's going to take hold. The Captain Al's been fishing 75 to 150 feet of water, and the word is the better cod fishing. Most of the cod are coming from the shallower water at this stage of the season. On the Freeport Star Stream, Captain Anthony switched over to mackerel, sailing Fridays through Sundays. They lumped them up on the weekend. Saturday was very good. Sunday was even better. Excellent mackerel fishing. Some guys walked off with 150 mackerel, so whether you want to put them away for smoking or you want to put them away for shark bait, you've got a good shot now of stocking the freezer with mackerel. Spoke to Billy at Chasing Tails Bait and Tackle in Oakdale. He's kind of right in the middle of, they get very involved with the perch fishing in the tidal creeks and also the tidal trout. Not much to report at all on trout in the tidal sections of rivers like the Connectquot and the Carmans. But he said the white perch are just getting started. He's been catching some. Most of the fish right now are being caught on worms, just a plain worm rig. But that should pick up as things move along. Some of the best fishing for that actually takes place later on in the winter, like in March. We've done very well. But he's been fishing the tidal Connectquot, and he said he is catching some fish. They're also running a shop contest. They went to contest for trout and perch. Real simple, just stop in at the shop in Oakdale, lay down your $20, and you're entered. And that's for the biggest trout and the biggest white perch. And that runs through April 31st. So if you want to participate in that, head on down to Chasing Tails. Some really good news on the freshwater front. Pretty exciting, actually. I'm sure a lot of you are aware of what's happened with Connectquot River State Park. You know, for the last few years now, it's been basically shut down. Unfortunately, a lot of people feel it was unjustified. The closing was based on IPN disease, and it's a long story, and we've covered it very heavily over the years. But they basically killed a world-class trout fishery, which a lot of us found very hard to justify. However, put a lot of work, a lot of money into restoring the hatchery and bringing the fishery back, and it's sounding really good. Just for an example, I talked to Paul over at River Bay Outfitters in Oceanside, and he had some guys from the Long Island Fly Rodders with him in the shop. They had an outing there on Monday. Some of them called it excellent, some of them called it spectacular. Just a lot of trout and good numbers of quality fish, 17, 18 inches, primarily brookies and rainbows. There's a few browns in the river, but it's primarily brookies and rainbows. And catching one of the usual woolly boogers. There's also a mop fly out there now. You can look that up, Google that if you want to see what that's all about. And amazingly, one guy did really well using a size 18 Adams dry fly this time of the year. Go figure. So, you know, sounds like it's really back, full swing. If you want to get in on the action there, it's $20 for a session. Right now, they're only open Wednesday to Sunday for the public. Monday and Tuesdays are for club outings. There are two sessions, 8 a.m. and noon. And you want to call 631-581-1005 to make a reservation on that. Also, while we're talking about fly fishing, River Bay offers fly tying courses right through the winter. Right now, Paul's doing 5 classes a week. He's got daytime and evening classes covering both saltwater flies and freshwater flies. So if you want to get in on that, give him a call, reserve a seat. It's 516-415-7748. So get in on that. And it's boat show time again. New York Boat Show rolls into town next Wednesday. We're going to be there. You want to stop by the booth if you want to take out a new subscription or renew your existing subscription. You can pick up a pair of these Star fishing pliers. We'll have them there for you. Show hours are noon to 9, Wednesday to Friday, 10 to 9 on Saturday, 10 to 5 on Sunday. And while you're there, you can also sit in on some good seminars, fishing seminars and boating seminars taking place during the show. Until next week, I'm Fred Golofaro for TheFisherman.com.
The Fishing News is brought to you by Shoreline Insurance Agency, Intelux Marine Paint, and Okuma.